Hello friends, very good evening. Myself Bala, I'm SEBI certified research analyst. I'm welcome you all to my YouTube channel, Talent Traders. So those who are new to my channel, kindly subscribe my YouTube channel. You will be getting lot of trading strategies and inside of the market trading system. So everything you are going to learn in this YouTube channel. So if you are a trader as well as an investor, you can subscribe the channel to get more updates. So in this video, I'm going to share my view on put call ratio. So a lot of people are confusing what is put call ratio. So you have to understand how we can use the put call ratio. And first of all, you understand what is put call ratio, then only you can manage your trade. So some websites showing put call ratio in a different manner. If the put call ratio is more, it's a bearish. Near about 1 minute, they are saying a bearish view. Some other website, they are saying when the put call ratio is more than one, they are saying a bullishness about the stock. So we have initial stage itself, we have a lot of confusion about put call ratio. So we have to experiment that put call ratio. Then we have understand what is the logic behind the trade and everything. We can know that the put call ratio. So here some website, when you are searching through Google, so you will be getting put call ratio, what it is put call ratio. Let's show you. While people are searching about a put call ratio in Google, you see that the put call ratio measurement is widely used by investor to gauge a overall mood of a market. A put option is right to sell an asset. It's not only right to sell an asset, we can manage by selling a put options to rights to buy the stock also, right? You have to understand that particular point. Okay, what about what the put call ratio? The put call ratio is the measurement and the same definition we have got, and we see the put call ratio what it is. And lot of website, they are given their explanation about put call ratio, but how as a trader we can use a put call ratio. So that is very important, right? The put call ratio, while we see some other websites, a lot of websites, they are explaining their way they are understood the put call ratio. So what they are telling, some website saying you the put call ratio is more, the put PCR is near about one, they are saying the bearishness about the stock, and some people saying bullishness about the same stock with the same number. For example, if the put call ratio of a particular stock, for example PCR is near about 1.03, let us assume some stocks, XYZ stocks having put call ratio of 0.13. some website, they are assuming that this was a bearish sign. Okay, some other website, the same scenario, they say bullish sign. So now as a trader, I was very confused. Either I can go for a bullish or either I can go for a bearish. So this is the way we confused by using put call ratio. So now I will give you some explanation and example with the real market. So how they were calculating the put call ratio? Total number of puts traded divided by call trader. So this is for a study case. I have taken a State Bank of India. This is the option chain from State Bank of India. Here you see that this is the total number of contract were traded. There will be two calculation is there to calculate put call ratio. First one is based on traded value, number of contract traded. So here exactly how they calculate the put call ratio. This is a put ratio, put traded, total volume, contract traded. So what they are doing, 4578 divided by 8082. So this is a total contract trader. So these two I'm taking a calculative person. Let calculate the put call ratio, 4578 divided by 8082. So this thing showing you the put call ratio of 0.56 as per total number of contract traded. Okay, let understand. And again, some people are using open interest, total open interest to calculate to PCR also, they are taken total open interest. Let's have to total open interest 357754000 divided by 552510000. So here you will be getting PCR by open interest we got a number of 0.64. So what it's saying, it was between the range, almost it's not near to 1 as well as is not below to 30. So it was a middle of this range. So now this stock, we cannot predict either it a bullish or a bearish. So once some stocks having the bearishness, more PCR or less PCR, let's have to calculate some other stocks to study purpose, more put PCR. Okay, so I'm explaining you how you have to understand. So DLF, so let's take. So now I'm not concluded anything from State Bank option chain. You'll see that this is the DLF contract which is trading 117, and this is the total contract which were trading futures. Okay, based on this, you see that PCR 11387600 based on total number of open interest. So 763000. So now you see that in this particular stock which having PCR, just these stocks having PCR is around 1.49. Some people saying this is a bearish view because lot of put traded, and here some website showing bullish. So whether which I want to take, so there is a initial confusion. Okay, and another thing, so which I can go for a based on contract trader. So 273 divided by 325. So here my PCR range for the stock is around PCR, this is based on open interest. Okay, here PCR is 0.84, it is a near about to 1. So people saying bearish, that we have understand, and another case bullish. So only two cases there, but all the two cases we are discussing here, what is the use of that? Okay, so first of all we have to understand what is the put call ratio, then only we can apply this trade system on when we can do that. So put call ratio is more, it means people saying bearish, right? Let's to open a calculation, we'll do it PCR. So how we can take a PCR as a education point, what is the logic behind the PCR, so that when understand we can know. So for example, when a stock was trading 100 rupees, assume stock was trading 100 rupees, people are interested to buy 100 in 5 call option, so around 5 rupees. For example, if I am very bullish about this particular stock, I am going to buy a 1000 contract, that is a 1000 lots I am going to buy. Now when the seller having this much of quantity, then only my trade got executed, right? So 1000 seller, I am a buyer, I am ready to buy, I know the stock will go up. So 1000 contract I am ready to buy. So when I can able to buy, there will be a 1000 seller. When the 1000 seller is there, that particular time only I can able to buy my 1000 quantity. So this seller may be a new seller, or they are already holding a position, they can sell their position, buyer. That means they are selling old position. So they may be already buyer, but now they are comes into the seller. So I don't know whether this was a new selling happen or a new buying happen. But as per my view, this is my new buying because I don't have the position. I am taking over a new position around 1000 contract. When this 1000 contract traded, understand 1000 contract traded, maybe my 1000 contract executed. Let us assume my 1000 contract is executed. In this case, already those who are owning their position, they may be selling 800 contracts. They exited 800 position and new 200 position selling happened. So what happened in this case? They are sold my position to me. I bought a 1000 quantity. This time, this call option having traded by 1000 quantity. But these 200 people are expecting downside in the stock. I am expecting upside in the stock. Okay, this is the logic. Other cases, I am ready to buy this much of quantity, but no new buyer. But those who are a fresh seller, almost 1000 seller are selling new seller. So they are selling my positions. What I am expecting bullish. These guys are expecting bearish. So the now the values are neutral in this particular way. This is new selling contract, new sale. This is new buy. So 1000 seller expecting downside, because they are selling a call option, their expectation should be downside in the same option. So I'll, before that I will explain you what are the conditions. For example, sell call. This is bearish view because you are expecting the stock will not go up. And buy call. So bullish. You understand? Using call option also we can express our bearishness. Using buying call option, not only by, if it means call option only, it denotes or it indicates the bullishness. Even we can use for a call option to express our bearish view also. So it is a little bit confusion to find out whether it's a new sell or a new buy or old position were squared up or a new position. In the same case also, some people are already selling their position, they can cover their position also. They are exiting their position. So you have to understand whether buying happened. Same like that, if it is happened 95. For example, 95 put option. This is what a call option. If the same new 1000 buy quantity happened and new 1000 sell quantity happened. So we don't know whether it is a old buy or old sell. For example, if the 1000 quantity happened in a put side, the same time 1000 quantity happened in a call side, if you are divided by, your PCR is around 1. This time we don't predict or we don't identify whether it is a happening for a bullish purpose or it is happening for a bearish purpose. So while what we have known from this factor and what we have understand from this factor, either it may be a bullish or bearish, I don't follow that. Either it may be bullish or bearish, I am not worried about that. But I know that lot of people, lot of option contract trader and lot of people believing the stock, either it goes up or goes down. That is the point we are getting from a PCR. Okay, lot of option traded, and also people are engaging with the more trade on the particular stocks, more trades. So means people are expected is more on the particular stock, either it may be upside or it may be a downside. So this is the view I am identifying from the particular stock. So once if you find those stocks which having more PCR, that not only telling you the direction of the stock, but telling you lot of trade were happened in this particular stocks. Once lot of trading happened, people may, some people are expecting bullishness and some other people are expecting bearishness. And finally, those who are expecting are those who are more powerful compared to buyer or seller to buyer. So those who are powerful, they can do or they can move their market on their direction. Okay, this is a if more buyer is more powerful, they can drag the market into up. If the sellers are more powerful, they can drag market into down. So we, and also we don't know and we cannot able to predict who will powerful. If that for example, 100 contract is traded in a particular stock, not only selling, you are buying a new buying or a new selling, we don't know, right? If you take an index, it's a lot of volume happening, but stocks, it is a comparatively very low to the index. But same cases, once you are finding out this much of lot of open interest, lot of PCR, so those stocks having more PCR, that particular stocks having high number of probability and option, that you have to understand in a single point. So those stocks having more PCR, that particular stock having high momentum, or the option contract which was traded more number compared to the other stocks. That is the understandable thing from using PCR. Okay. Now I'll share you some other trade details or some other points where we get a more PCR. So this Excel which I taken 22nd of this month. So here 22nd of this month I'm taking this Excel. You see that when I taken, these are the put call ratio which I sorted by top to bottom. You see that these are the stocks having more put call ratio is more than one. It not only telling you the all the stocks are downtrend. Okay, Nifty, IT, PEL, M&M, Axis Bank, TVS Motor, Maruti, Bank Nifty, Bajaj Finance. So these stocks having more PCR. Okay, understand? Having these stocks having more PCR. So once we know that more PCR is 0 1.1 plus, okay, so not indicating bearishness, you have to understand. We have to it may be have the possible to bullish also, because more trading happen, that is the meaning. Put call ratio comparatively, for example, if people buying 100 put same time 100 call, your PCR is 1. So what you, how you can find out the direction of the stock? Or else you can take a 1000 contract which is traded. Well, we have, this is a put option divided by call option, number of call option. So if it is 1000 means the put call ratio is 1. So now 1 is not only indicating it is a bearishness. So in this case, if the seller is powerful, they may drag the market down. If this buyer is more powerful, they may drag the market up. So you have to understand, okay, put call ratio. So while how you can do that on 22nd, if you see that 22nd, this DLF was among the toughest PCR. Okay, so let's open that DLF on a chart. How I can do the trading while the stocks having more put call ratio? Simply, so simple and more effective, and you can do the options too, nothing worry. Even 5 minute chart or 10 minute chart, whatever the chart time frame, you can focus and you can follow, and you can find out whether the trade opportunity. Once you find out the trade opportunity, you can fix your stop loss and start your trading now. So this is the 14th October, this is the 22nd October. From 22nd October, the stock went huge. Okay, I was taken this Excel by 22nd around 12:30. Okay, in the morning. So it is a live market hours. I have taken this PCR rate. So you see that market is going up, PCR is increasing. Okay, you understand, this particular area I have taken, this particular time I have taken PCR is 1.6. So means PCR is bearish, means the stock must have to come, but it not happen. It was, instead of that, it increasing. What is the meaning of PCR? So lot of people are buying in a particular stock. You may also try to buy or sell according to the trend of the market. Okay, it is a strong bullish candle and big also. So more buyers in the powerful hand. So once the stock comes below that level, so simple, I'm telling you about the simple candlestick analysis. Once the stock falls below that, we have to maybe change, or else if it is keep on going up, means so still it wasn't bullish. So you have to understand first of all again. Same thing, I will open in a 5 minute chart or a 15 minute chart, whatever the time frame. So here I am using 15 minute chart. I am not able to find out the trend of the particular stock. Okay, I am not able to find the trend of the particular stock. So instead of that, I am using simple super trend method. So the super trend, which is available in a lot of trading platform, I am using simple super trend of 15 minute chart. You see that on 22nd, what happened? 22nd, the stock was started by positive and it was trading by positive. So here lot of put call ratio, from there after that it went up and ending with a positive one. So if you are buying a call option also, you are in still profit. So I'm in a 15 minute chart, when it sell you try to buy, and when it buy, and so that you have to do. But once you understand how the trend is going on, the trend is going on and now it is making a flag pattern, but trend is positive. So once you understand the trend, now I'm opening the 16 minute chart. So the positional I'm going to take, this trend was started by 14th and it was on buying. So 22nd, it gives a first bullish candle, and prior to that it was in bullish mode only. So once you find out the trend, you can trade along with the direction. Okay, so once you know the trend, first of all, and Hindustan Unilever, Bajaj Finance, so I'm not interested to do Hindustan Unilever because it was not a good for options. And I'm taking a Bajaj Finance. You see that Bajaj Finance, this is what, and also it happened a result on the some particular day. So it's showing a selling direction. Okay, from 4018, and next day it started because this, due to the news it forms. And if you take in a 4000 put option also, this time it comes to 3900, more than 100 points down. So what you see that both the stocks, DLF and Bajaj Finance, which forms more PCR. DLF also high PCR and Bajaj Finance also high PCR, but high PCR is high. In this case, DLF forms upside, Bajaj Finance forms downside. So both is, some people are saying one the PCR is more, bearish. It happened here. Some people are saying PGR is high, they are bullish. Here also possible. So they are having two kind of ideas. Both are working in the market. But while we are doing a trading, we must focus both the sides. So DLF or 16 minute chart where buy. So I am going to buying direction. Bajaj Finance 16 minute chart. I am going to selling direction. So put call ratio, it indicates you. We have to know there will be a lot of option buyers and sellers are playing with the stocks. So that is the important point we have to understand. Then only we can make money. And Maruti. Maruti also having that kind of more PCR. You see that Maruti, what happened? I'm taken one hour chart. So this is the 22nd, which forms a big momentum in upside. After that, it started fall. And finally it moving up. So Maruti having more PCR, but it not getting down. It instead of that, it going up. So how I can find out the very easiest way, while I know the trend of the stocks, once I know the trend of the stock, I can easily make money from the market. Once the put call ratio is more, that stocks you can select, and then you can follow with the any other indicator. So what that indicator is saying you the direction, you can follow the direction. And iShare motor, which forms a even more momentum. iShare motor put call ratio is more, and hourly chart is in buy, and it started moving up and up. This is the 22nd. That time it was not turning a red, but after that it started moving up and up, and from there 22nd it was trading around almost 20,000. Now it is 1,300, 1,400, 1,600 points. It's more than the particular day. So if you follow this system, so your stop loss also there, and you know the stop loss and where to exit, you know that, and where to enter, you know that. So once you knowing this all the parameters, you can start your trading using PCR. I think now you understand. If you have any doubt on PCR, this is what PCR, how to use. So once you have the more PCR stocks, you can follow, and you can follow any other chart. I'm not only telling you, you can follow super trend. The super trend, a layman can easily understand the super trend. That's why I'm explaining my strategies with the super trend. But my strategy is the selection is very important. Once you selected the right stock, you can apply any other indicators to find out your direction of the particular stocks. Once you know the direction, you are going to make money on the market. So without tension and without knowing your risk and reward factor. And if you like this video, you can share to your friends. And those who are not subscribed my channel, kindly subscribe the channel. And thanks for watching. Thanks for being with me. And thank you very much.